गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर दैट इज एमाइंस. एमाइंस आर द डेरिवेटिव्स ऑफ एमोनिया. नाउ व्हाई दे आर नोन एज डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एमोनिया, बिकॉज दे आर गोइंग टू बी ड्राइव फ्रॉम एमोनिया बाय सब्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ वन ऑफ द हाइड्रोजन ऑफ एल्काइल ग्रुप. For example, we have ammonia and we are substituting one hydrogen by one alkyl group. So it will going to give RnH2. That is known as primary amine. If we are substituting two hydrogen with two alkyl group, then it will going to give us R2NH. That is known as secondary amine. And if we are substituting all the three hydrogen by the three alkyl group, then it will going to form R3NH, and which is known as tertiary amine. Apart from this, other compounds which contain nitrogen, they are cyanide, isocyanide, nitro and disonium chloride. Amines can also be classified into aliphatic amines and aromatic amines. Aliphatic amines, like we have CH3NH2 or we have CH3NHCH3 or we have CH3NCH3CH3. Now let's see aromatic amines. Aromatic amines are again classified into two types of amines. First will be aryl amine, and second will be aryl alkyl amine. Aryl amine means in which the NH2 group is directly attached to the benzene ring, whereas in aryl alkyl amine, the amine group will not be directly attached with the benzene ring. So let's see the examples of alkyl amine. The first example is, we have with the benzene ring NH2 group is attached. The common name for this is aniline. As you can see in this, the amine group is directly attached to the benzene ring. Next is, we have benzene NH, and with this another benzene ring is attached. As you can see in this, the benzene ring is directly attached to the amine group, so it will come in the category of aryl amine, and it is known as diphenyl amine. Next is, let's see the examples of aryl alkyl amine. In this, if we have benzene ring CH2NH2. Now this group is known as benzyl, so it will be known as benzyl amine. Benzyl amine. Now if we have benzene CH2NH CH2 with the benzene ring, now in this the NH group is not directly attached to the benzene ring. It is known as dibenzyl amine. Now let's talk about nomenclature. First is, if we have CH3NH2, the common name for this will be methyl amine. Second is if we have CH3 and HCH3. Now you can see two methyl groups are attached, so it will be known as dimethyl amine. Third is if we have CH3 and NH C2H5. Now in this two different groups are attached, so in this case we will going to name according to alphabetical order. So this is ethyl and this is methyl. So first ethyl will come, so it will be ethyl methyl amine. Now let's talk about IUPAC name. IUPAC name we will going to name according to alkamine. Now in this if we have CH3 NH2, then it is known as methanamine. If we have CH3 CH2 NH2, then it will be known as ethanamine. Now if we have CH3 NH CH3, then it will be known as N-methyl methanamine. Next is CH3 NHC2H5. Now as you can see in this two different groups are present, so in this we will going to name according to that smaller group will be taken as alkyl group. So it will be known as N-methyl ethanamine. Now next is we have CH3, CH, CH2, NH2, CH3. Now 1, 2 and 3, it will be known as 2-methyl propanamine. Next is if we have NH2, CH2, CH2, NH2. 1 and 2, it will be known as ethane 1,2-diamine. Next is let's talk about aromatic amines. First is the most common example, that is with the benzene ring NH2 group is attached, the common name will be aniline and the IUPAC name is benzamine. Benzamine. Now if we have NH CH3, now in this the name will be N-methyl benzamine. Next is if we have NCH3CH3, then it will be known as NN-dimethyl benzamine. Let's see last nomenclature, that is NH2CH3. Now it will be known as 2-methyl benzamine. I hope you have understood the nomenclature. Now let's see isomerism. The first isomerism is chain isomerism. For example, if we have हैव CH3, CH2, 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 NH2. Now the chain isomer of this will be CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, NH2. Or we can write it as C, CH3, 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 CH2, NH2. These three are the chain isomer of each other. As you can see in this, the molecular formula is same, but the chain is different. The second isomer that amines can show, that is position isomerism. In this, if we have CH3, CH2, CH2, NH2. The isomer of this will be CH3, CH, NH2, CH3. As you can see in this, the molecular formula is same, but the position of functional group is different. The next isomer that amines can show, that is metamerism. For example, if we have CH3, CH2, NH, CH2, CH3. Now in this, you can see on both sides, ethyl group is present. And if we have CH3, CH2, CH2, NH, CH3. And here, on one side, propyl is present and on one side, methyl is present. So in these two, the number of alkyl groups are different around the functional group. So, amines can show chain isomerism, position isomerism, and metamerism. I hope you have understood today's topic. That's all for today. Have a nice day ahead.